This conference will now be recorded.
The Thursday class topic is like
garbage collection.
Garbage collection, like we done with system RGC method, right? So to call a garbage collector.
Yes.
The system RGC we are calling. The second way you can call a garbage collector like runtime.gc method, guys. Even runtime class also having the GC method to call a garbage collector basically. Your runtime class also having a GC method to call a garbage collector, right? Yes, our main intention is give the object to garbage collector. How to give the object to the garbage collector means assigning null value to the object, right? Assigning null value to the object. Yeah? Once you assign null value to the object means then what happened here? Initially T1 is pointing to object. Now T1 is pointing to null. If T1 is pointing to null, then what happened is then T1 is pointing to null. Then T1 is point null means what happened here? Then this object is eligible to garbage collector, right? Exactly, guys. Yes, there are two ways you can call the garbage collector. One is a system class GC method. The second one is what? A runtime class GC method, guys. And system class GC is a static method. Then how can we call a static method? Because system.gc is a static method. We can call a static method using class name, right? Because you can call a static method using class name. What about runtime class GC method? Runtime class GC is like instance method, guys, basically. Runtime class GC is like instance method, right? Exactly. See, guys, yesterday same topic, like same point here. But yesterday we are creating object yesterday we are using like system.gc we are calling. But in place of system.gc, I have runtime r equal to runtime.getRuntime method. Because basically, getRuntime is a method belongs to which class, guys? Runtime class. It returns which object? Which returns like runtime object, right? Just returns which object means returns what? Runtime object, right? Exactly, guys. Runtime.getRuntime method. Runtime.getRuntime method. GetRuntime method returns which object? Runtime.getRuntime method returns which object means runtime object, right? Exactly, guys. Just returns which object means what? Runtime object, right? Exactly. So we are calling r.gc method, guys. So you can save this code local disk E. The file is called test.java file. Just open the command prompt. Local disk E. CLS Java C application is called what? And test.java. Code is compiled fine. So Java the class is called class here. Test class, right? So you guys, we got the output like object destroyed, we got how many times total? We got the output is 2 times, right? Exactly. Initially we have the objects, guys. Next we are destroying that objects. So that's what object destroyed may execute twice, right? Exactly. Is it clear now? Yeah, that is information, guys. And after that, if you see runtime class, guys. Using runtime class even you can interact with runtime resources also. Because using runtime class even interact with what? Runtime resources, right? Runtime resource instance like memories, guys. Like memories also we can call. Like memories also we can use. See here, for example, if you see this code, I'm creating runtime object. This runtime class is bit important. Using runtime class, you can call the garbage collector. We can open the system resources and we can check the memory sizes, like memories. Good. This runtime r equal to runtime.getRuntime method. Yes, actually here we didn't use the new keyword to create the object, guys, and we are calling runtime.getRuntime method. GetRuntime returns the object basically. Just GetRuntime method, this method is return the object. That's why we are storing that object into runtime class, right? Exactly. Because using runtime class, we can interact the memories also. R dot total memory is how much? R dot total memory is how much? R dot free memory is how much? R dot total memory and R dot free memory, right? Exactly. Guess total memory is like R dot total memory. How much total memory is there? How much free memory is there? I'm creating this many number of objects, guys. Almost all like 1 lakh objects I'm creating, right? If you're creating 1 lakh objects, guys, after 1 lakh objects, free memory is how much? After creation of 1 lakh object, the free memory we have to check. R dot free memory, right? Exactly. So after creation of 1 lakh object, definitely free memory reduced, right? Free memory reduced. Then we are calling R dot GC. Then what happened, guys? Yeah? We are calling the garbage collector to destroy some of the useless objects, right? So useless object destroyed means what happened, guys? Again, free memory reduced or increased? Yes, free memory is definitely increased, right? Yes, free memory is what increased, right? Exactly, guys. see the output here. Code is compiled fine. So Java class is college class here. Test class. Initial memory is how much? 67 something like 1084 bytes format basically. It is. Pre memory is like 65. 65 is there. After 1 lakh objects, pre memory reduced, right? Reduced to 64, right? Then I'm calling the garbage collector. If I'm calling the garbage collector after calling the garbage collector, then what happened, guys? Pre memory increase, right? Yes, after calling the garbage collector, the pre memory increased or not? Definitely pre memory is what? Pre memory is increased, right? Exactly, guys. Pre memory increased, right? Exactly. Yes, to check the memories, basically, to check the memories, total how many memory, how much total memory is there, how much free memory is there. To call the memories you are going for each class, guys, even the runtime class we can use. We can use what? Runtime class, right? Exactly. The runtime class use it to interact with our runtime resource, right?
Ratan sir, is there, will there be any difference if we create an object using a new keyword?
There's no difference, but internally they're using new keyword, maybe. Runtime
okay. Get. So I mean there will not be any difference if I write this runtime R is equal to new runtime.
But they won't, their intention is like they are not exposing like object creation process to you. Actually, they won't expose like object creation process to you, just they are giving this method. You can call that method, the method return the object. How they internally create the object, you don't know, right?
Okay. Okay.
Because we have a multiple ways you can create the object, actually. That's what.
Okay.
Yeah, runtime class basically to recall the runtime resources, garbage collector, and we are checking the memories, right? We are checking what memories, guys. And even system resource like I want to open the Notepad, MS Paint, the calculator, these all are system resources, right? Because even the first example, you are calling a garbage collector, second example, you are checking the memories. Third example, you can see runtime r equal runtime dot get runtime method. Exec command is there. Exec method, it will open the Notepad execution file. Exec file, Notepad, MS Paint, calculator, right? Yes, Notepad, MS Paint, and what? Calculator is there, right? Exactly. Because if you run this code, then what happened, guys? It will open how many system resources total here? 3 system resources, right? Exactly. Because it throws an exception like IO exception. So compile time, compile is giving information with the checker type and checker type. You have to checker type exception. That's what we have to handle the exception using throws key, right? Throws exception at hand handle. Because system resource means what? If main or system resource not available, we got the issue, right? That's what. Code is compiled fine. The Java class is called what? Test class. See, guys, Notepad is opened first. Next, MS Paint is opened. Then calculator is opened. The calculator is already opened here, right? Yeah. The calculator is open here. MS Paint is open. Like that, while doing the application, if you want to open the resources like this Notepad, Notepad, MS Paint, calculator, to open this kind of resources, then you can go for like, yes, we can use what? You can use like runtime class, right? Runtime R equal runtime dot get runtime. Exec command, right? Exactly.
So Ratan sir, if I want to open a particular file in Notepad, I mean if it is located in a particular path in my hard drive, so can we pass the value as a path?
No, we can't do like that.
Okay.
These are the by default system resources, right? Notepad, MS Paint, calculator, these all. In that case, operating system will locate that libraries because runtime class is able to interact the operating system, right? Because even memories with the RAM, right? So it's hard, like with the operating system, right? That's what runtime class is able to interact with the operating system. That's it. Example for even if you restart the system, guys, this is like shut down the system. This is like a restart the system. So if you run this code, then what happened, guys? Your application will be shut down. Your operating system will be shut down. So exec to shut down the data, hyphen s, right? Should restart the data, hyphen r is there. Like this, you have to. Yes, total runtime class, we saw like total 4 examples, guys. First example, using runtime class, you are calling the garbage collector. Second example, using runtime class, you are checking the memories. And third example, using runtime class, you open the system resources like Notepad, MS Paint, and calculator. fourth example, like you are shut down the system and restart the system, guys. Shut down the system and what to restart the system, right? Exactly. Is it clear now?
Only system resource can be open, not any kind of an URLs, right? If I want to open any of the application URLs, it doesn't
application is not possible, right? Because that is a web application, advanced Java. In advanced Java, we have to open the browser and we have to send the request and response, right? Client side architecture required. Here it won't open like any browser's concept and all. Only system resources like calculator, MS Paint, MS Word, Excel files, those files you can open. Yeah. I guess one point you can see here, how many ways you can call the garbage collector? Yesterday we saw like one approach, today we saw like one approach. System class GC and runtime class GC. Which one is better approach here? Is it system class GC or runtime class GC? Guess which one is better means actually runtime class GC only can call the garbage collector, guys. Guess which class you can see? Runtime class API is there. Only runtime class GC only can call the garbage collector. See, for example, runtime class is there. So see, guys, every Java application has a single instance of a runtime. Unless the application interface environment is running, the current runtime can be a get runtime method, right? The current runtime can be obtained from the get runtime method, right? Yeah, get runtime method here. So exec command is there, exit is there, gc method you have to check. So guys, gc method you can call runs the garbage collector, guys. Calling this method is suggested Java virtual machine, something like this one currently occupied available quick reuse. This part is quick reuse, right? When you control the method call, virtual machine made the effort recycle the Discord object, right? Exactly. The name GC stands for garbage collector. The virtual machine performs the recycling process that you needed. If separated, even if the GC method is invoked explicitly. Yeah, read this point. Okay? The system.gc is a conventional and convenient means the system, the method system.gc is, guys. Conventional and what is point, guys? What's the meaning of this line, Usman, what's the meaning of this line? The system.gc is what?
Conventional, sir.
An easier way.
The method system.gc is like conventional and convenient, huh? That is
conventional, yes, means sir, I can kind of older methods, like, I mean, conventional things like we use in our past.
This one convenient,
huh? Convenient.
This method, the method system.gc is a conventional and convenient means invoking of this method, huh? What the meaning, instead of calling this VGC, that VGC is recommended, which, what is the meaning? Yaar, tell me, yaar. Rani?
System.gc is an easier way of calling, invoking.
System.gc is saying easier way, huh? Okay, fine, guys. He's saying like system.gc is a conventional direct way, right? Exactly. But unfortunately, for you, it is easy way, guys. Instead of creating runtime object, instead of creating runtime object, he's saying like what? Simply system.gc is okay, right?
Mm-hmm.
System.gc is okay. But unfortunately, a system.gc internally calling the runtime.gc only. System.gc internally calling what? Runtime.gc. If you want to see that point here, if you open a system class code, okay? System class source code in Java. System class source code in Java. Just open the system class source code, guys. If you open, this is like system class source code. In the source code, what do you need? You need like which method here? GC method, right? If you need like GC method now, yeah. See this code, guys. This is a GC method, right? See this code, guys, here. Public stat GC is which method, guys, now? This is like system class code, right? This system class static method or not? See, guys, this system class GC method, what it is doing? Runtime.getRuntime.gc, right? Runtime.getRuntime is getting runtime object. Then dot gc is calling directly, right? This is called named object, nameless object.
Nameless
object, right? It means what? See, even though it is a convenient approach when compared to runtime class object, system.gc is a convenient approach. But system.gc internally calling which approach is runtime.gc only. It says that which one can call directly garbage collector, guys? Which one can call the runtime. Yeah. the call, see this one, if you want to check the API documentation once, you want to see the runtime class API, system class API documentation of system class API. If you go for system class API, guys, because previously we checked like runtime class API. So now we are checking like system class API. System class API can go for GC method now. The GC method, see guys, last point you see, the call system.gc is effectively equivalent to what? Is equivalent to what is called, right? Yes, finally we decided, even though you are calling system.gc, is that system.gc directly calling the garbage collector, it is calling internal runtime.gc only? Because it is internally calling what? It is internally calling which method, guys? Runtime.gc, right? Yes, yes or no? It is internally calling which method means runtime.gc, right? Exactly. Then what is the point, guys, direct pointer? So there are two ways you can call the garbage collector. You have to understand the system.gc, runtime.gc. But which one is a convenient approach, guys? System.gc is a convenient approach. But who is calling the garbage collector directly? Yes, but who is calling the garbage collector directly? Exactly. That clarity important, guys. Because when you check this kind of points in API documentation, directly can understand, right? They are saying system.gc is a convenient approach. But the system.gc is equivalent to what? Runtime.gc, right? Because when you check the source code, a system.gc internally calling which method, guys? Runtime.gc, right? Exactly, guys. So there are two ways you can call the garbage collector, but which one is a convenient approach means what? System.gc is a convenient approach, guys. But system.gc internally calls what? Runtime.gc to call the garbage collector, right? Yes, to call what? To call the garbage collector, right? Exactly. Is it clear now? Good. The system class is internally calls what? Runtime.gc, right? Yeah. So runtime class total, we executed four examples, guys. You try to check these four examples once.
So usually we don't use runtime.gc, sir.
That's what I'm saying. Which one is a convenient approach? System.gc or runtime.gc
system,
means
system.gc. And it is a recommended one also, right?
Yeah. So developer point of it is recommended, okay. But if you're asking like, is a system, some interviews the experience guys, they'll ask the question like, is system class just directly can call the garbage collector?
Okay.
And then
where this question fits, okay.
Yeah, so experience guys, if they ask this type of question, well, definitely.
Okay.
In this case, what is output now? So I have like, this is like finalized method. This is employee class is there. This is like student class is there. And a test class contains a finalized method. So I assume like finalized method got executed before destroying the object, right? Here T object is eligible to garbage collector, employee object is eligible to garbage collector, so student object is eligible to garbage collector, right? Then I'm calling the garbage collector, system.gc I'm calling, right? Exactly. If you are calling system.gc, then what happened just now? Then you're calling like system.gc means then what happened? Here, how many objects are eligible to garbage collector total?
Two.
Three, sir.
Three objects, right? Yes. Because here, three objects are eligible to garbage collector means, how many times the finalized method got executed here?
Three times.
This finalized method executed like one time or three times?
Three times.
Exactly. But that is wrong actually. This finalized method got executed only once. The point is here, you said like three objects are destroyed, that is fine. But three objects are destroyed like, yeah. What is compile, why? Yeah, how they destroyed. See, in some cases objects are not destroyed, right? Because internally it follows some algorithms, guys, basically. Internally it follows some algorithm to destroy the objects. Huh? That's what some case objects are not destroying. And here objects are destroying, right? Exactly. So internet follows like mark and sweep algorithm to destroy the objects, guys. Because internet follows such algorithm, mark and sweep algorithm to destroy the object, right? Exactly. And see guys, actually here only which class, which may executing test object destroyed, this may only executing, right? The reason is like, here see, test object eligible to garbage collector, employee student object eligible to garbage collector, but JVM here, what happened, you know, if test object destroyed means then what happened, guys? Test class finalized method got executed, guys. Test object destroyed means what? Test class finalized method got executed. If employee object destroyed means what? Employee class finalized method got executed, guys. student object destroyed means student class file is executed, right? Because don't think like for these all objects only this class this class file is method got executed. Which object is destroyed, that class file is method executed. The statement is clear. Which object is destroyed, that class file is method got executed, right? Yes, which object
and
is destroyed?
Don't have any overridden finalize method. That's why it is not filling up the memory of these two objects.
So if you write the finalize method, if you write the finalize method here, then what happened, guys? Then which object is destroyed? That class finalize method got executed, right?
Ratan sir, if I extend those two classes, I mean, if I extend, can you go to that? Sorry. Yeah, if I extend those two classes, those empty classes with the third one, the test one in which finalize method is there, and we execute the same code, then definitely there will be three test object destroyed messages, right?
If you're extending,
yeah, then that.
Try to check that example extension operation, but we didn't check the extension operation. You try to check that example, if working fine, please let me know tomorrow class, okay?
Okay.
Here code is compiled now. That this point, this example intention is clear. This example intention is what? If which object executed, which object is destroyed, that class finalize method got executed basically. Because here two objects destroyed, objects are not destroying, object are destroying, two objects destroying. Some cases three objects are destroying. Exactly. That depends on what internal algorithms guys. Definitely. Multiple objects are eligible to garbage collector, then garbage collector definitely has to follow some internal algorithms to destroy the objects, right? It has to follow internal algorithm to destroy the objects, guys. That internal algorithm they implemented like mark and sweep algorithm. Mark it and sweep it. Mark it and sweep it. Mark and sweep algorithm, right? Exactly. If this example intention is what? This example simply intention is like. What is the example of intention, guys? Yeah. Which object is destroyed, that class finalize method got executed basically. Yes, which object is destroyed, that class finalize method got executed, right? Exactly. Good. There is to a small observation, you try to see these observations once. Here my M1 method return type is what? Yes, here what is my M1 method return type?
Employees.
Employee. M1 method return type is like employee. If M1 method return type is employee means, then I'm creating two employee objects, E1, E2 is there. Then I returned E1, right? I returned E1. In the main method, what I'm doing here, new test.m1, we are calling M1 like, we are calling M1. After that M1, what we are doing like, we are holding that M1 employee object, right? Exactly. Because in M1 method, our intention is like, we have to focus on M1 method. In M1 method, how many objects are created total? Yes, in M1 method, how many objects are employee objects are created?
Objects are created.
How many employee objects are created M1 method? In M1 method, two employee objects are created, right? Exactly. With these two objects, how many objects are eligible to garbage collector? Even once this example is completed, once this M1 method is complete, I'm talking about only M1 method, guys. Once the M1 method is completed, how many objects are eligible to garbage collector?
Objects.
That is the question. Once this M1 is completed, how many objects are eligible to garbage collector?
Two questions. Sorry, two objects.
I'm not writing system, but
after M1 completes.
Well, after M1 completes, how many
objects are
eligible to
garbage collector? That's the question. E1 and E2. No, sir. Only E2. Because only E2. we are returning E1.
We are holding at E1, right?
Yes.
We are holding, that means what? Still that object existence is there, right?
Exactly. Ratan sir, you are not audible.
So you are under mute.
Okay, so after M1 is complete, how many objects are able to garbage collector now? Guys, how many objects are eligible to garbage collector now?
E2.
Only one. Guys, because here we are returning E1, right? We are returning E1 and we are holding E1. It means E1 still existence is there, right? There's still E1 existence is there, right? That's what only here, which object is eligible to garbage collector means only E2 objects are eligible to garbage. Some case they'll give you this type of question, they'll ask like how many objects are eligible to garbage collector, right? Exactly. With this example, how many objects are eligible to garbage collector? Tell me now. Here also, I'm targeting only M1 method, guys. In M1 method, how many objects we created? Two objects we created, right? I returned E1. Then we are calling test.m1. Then tell me, guys, here how many objects are able to garbage collector now?
Two, sir.
I think here two, right? Why it is two? Why here it is two?
We are not holding that return type.
Even though you return object, but are you holding that object or not means definitely we are not holding that object, right? We are not holding that object means then what happened is we got the we are not holding that object means that also we eligible to garbage collector, right? Like that. Previous example, we are holding the object, that's what the object eligible. We are holding that object means still object existence is there, that's what one object eligible to garbage collector. But here we are not holding the object, right? Here we are not holding the object means what happened is then two objects eligible to garbage collector, right? Yes, two objects are eligible to garbage collector. Yes, yes or no? Good. Yes, today just to discuss runtime class and finalize method and finalize method and what? Just small observation, right? Exactly. Okay, this is basically like working with the garbage collector. You try to check this garbage collector, guys. Yes, today there is no advanced Java class. I have some work. I have to move some more. I have to go outside. Today no class, advanced Java no class, guys. And tomorrow we'll meet and tomorrow we'll start like
Ratan sir yes to you did not upload the yesterday's class notes also
because they can't notes are
yeah
notes I will take care
for garbage collector
guys is it videos are uploading properly
yes
it day basis
yeah
can you hold here new test method of M1 which we are assigning it to EMPE that's why when M1 method is completed we are not releasing that resources that's why we are able to release only E2 in the previous example is that my understanding right
previous example what we are doing we are returning the object we are holding that object right
in the main method is it right
in the main method you're holding that object it means what still that object reference is existed right
yeah even is returning value that's why M1 method is holding it
yeah exactly now see this address E1 here this address and this E address both are addresses are same right because yes. Here we are returning E1 and we are holding that E1 into the E variable right that's for the both addresses are same actually if you want you can run this code see the both addresses memory addresses see memory address both are same right 1B5 1D5
yeah
good but okay. Second case what we are not holding right we are not holding means what that is also eligible to garbage collector right that's what intention no
by guess tomorrow will meet the yesterday's class notes also
both notes are uploaded
okay thank you so much
By guess tomorrow we'll meet and tomorrow we'll start a new topic. Okay.
Thank you, sir.